All right. Just a couple of things I wanted to go over real quick before we get started with this bar build that I'm attempting. First thing I just want to say, this is not my design. I got this off the internet from Pinterest. I found a home bar ideas and clicked through some pictures and found this Milligan's Gander Hill Farm bar that he built. It's a bunch of still frame pictures and some directions on what he did. So this is basically his design, a little modified for my needs. So basically, what I've done so far is just cut some wood to the dimensions I need. These are 2x6s. I laid out this little taped area for where my bar is going to go. The reason why it's in two sections is because I'm eliminating the bottom plate right in the middle here. That's just to give me more room for behind the bar, because I'm putting in a kegerator, and that's 26 inches long, deep I should say. And it's already tight behind here because that's going to bring me out past the bar width. So by eliminating that bottom plate, I'm able to tuck that kegerator right up against the back wall there, and it give me about another 5.5-6 inches with the plywood sheathing. So basically I cut these studs here at 36 inches, that with the bottom plate and top plate, which will be a double top plate, brings the overall height of the bar frame to 40.5 inches. I'm going to be using 3/4 inch ply for the top, two pieces for an additional 1.5 inches, bringing the overall bar height to 42 inches, which is pretty standard for a bar. So right now, I cut these to size and pre-drilled using a bit to recess the heads of the screws so they sit flush. That's just my preference. So right now I'm just gonna screw all these two walls together, and I'll get back to you. Your name is not Jack Brown. You're the dirty hack that shot your woman down. Yes, oh yes, my name is Willie Lee. If you got a... All right, so here are the first two walls up and roughly in place. I haven't secured them yet to the floor, but you notice I have this gap in here like we talked about, missing the bottom plate, so I still got to come across with the double top plate. That'll go right across, tying both of these walls in together. Plus I'm putting up a smaller wall here, probably 36 inches or so, coming in this way on both sides, and that's where the keg's gonna slide right in, but right up against the back wall here. So I gotta build these two walls, and then the end of the bar here is gonna come over into an L, so I'll build another wall like this. These are the recessed screws. Just keeps it flush. Another wall here I'll put in. Get those other two walls built. Those I'm going to do out of 2x4. Because behind the bar is all going to be... the rest will be 2x4. This will be 2x6. And then the frame should be complete. Okay. Got the outside wall done for the bar here. That's basically the layout for the outside. I'm going to be building the two side walls that'll make up the cabinet here behind the bar. I already pre-cut all the wood here and again drilled it. So I'll be making those walls next, and we'll get those in place. I had to make these. These are basically, it's gonna come to about here. Don't forget, I gotta put another top plate on this, plus the 2 3/4 inch plywood, which will bring that up another 4.5 inches. But because of this tray I'm gonna be using for my kegerator, it's got some plumbing that I gotta need the room between the top of the kegerator and the back shelf here. So I had to make the back shelf is actually gonna be about 38 inches. Normally it's about 36 inches. So that puts me right in this area here. A little higher than I wanted to, but you know what are you gonna do? Alright, so what I got so far coming along. So it's pretty much just the outside frame, not even complete yet, but just to give you an idea of what's going on or what my thought process is. I'm going to throw another 2x6 across to tie that in, and then one more across the whole top, 10-footer. The bar itself is, the framing is just shy of 10 feet out to here. Just shy of 10 feet. And this will be almost over 2 feet here, and plus whatever I put on the end for bar rail. Of course, it's not squared up or tied into the floor yet. I just sat it there. I just got to level it all out. This is vinyl here over tile, which is over concrete. So I was debating on shooting it, but I didn't know how that was going to affect the tile. I didn't want it caving in, so I just grabbed the all-purpose masonry tile, whatever bit, and some of these concrete lags. I'll try using that, see how it goes. So that's it. I think I'm gonna maybe secure this one in first and square this one up and secure it in and then finish tying it in. Let's see if I can get that done. Alright, here's what I got so far. Finished framing up those two walls for the side for the keg. I got everything secured to the floor. I ended up shooting them. The drill and the lag bolt thing wasn't really working out. Did kind of feel in some spots it busted the tile underneath it, but the nails were long enough to go to the concrete anyway, so it worked out. Already had run that plumbing for the sink back here. Top plate's on, double plate. It's pretty solid. So I think I'm going to run some electrical now, and then put the plywood. Let me come on around this side here. I'll put the plywood on it and maybe stain it, just the outside. All right, I'll get you in the next one. All right, I got the outside sheathing. It's a 1/2 inch oak plywood on the front. This seam here will be covered by a piece of trim I got planned for. And that's basically where we're at. I'm gonna stain it right now and get that done. It's getting late, so I figure I'll end with that and then it'll dry overnight. And you can continue from there. Okay, just an update here. I started running the electrical. Put up a wall back here, which I have to take down because I forgot I want to run the plumbing through the wall. Just like the electrical here. Get ready for the cake. Got another wall here cut and ready to install. But what I've been working on here is my step. What I did was, using 2x4s, made the height, which overall it's going to be around 7.5 to 8 inches. I ran another 2x4 right down the middle here to give me the width I need, keeping in mind that I'm going to be adding some trim here that will take it out to about an inch. So this, when it's all said and done, will be about a 7.5 inch width by about an 8 inch height. And I kind of just use some support studs here to nail it. And now I'm working on putting on some plied wood on the top here. I'm probably going to just put some tile for the step part, and then a piece of trim right here in front. It's a 1x8, but it's really 7.25, so I thought it was 7.5, but they're 7.25. So I might have to get a 1x10 and rip it to the width I want if it's not high enough. But we'll get to that. Right now, I just wanted to update you. Oh, I stained the front black. Probably going to put another coat of stain before I poly it. And then start adding the trim that I want to put on. Alright. So I'll just update you here. It's been a few days since we checked in last. Today is Saturday the 12th, I believe. Alright, back to work. Okay, today's progress. I went ahead and, I felt that step was a little too wide, so I took that center. I don't know if this is the next day, so I forget exactly what I showed, but I had a 2x4 running down the middle, sandwiched between the two, that gave it an extra inch and a half. I took that out. I wanted it that wide, so now it's just a 2x4 side by side, giving it 7 inches. And I added the slate top here, which I still have to grout and stuff. Came around here. This is just a filler board, basically, to give it some dimension. I'm putting another piece of trim over this, and then a step down piece will go here, smaller piece, so it'll have a little step dimension, and then frame it out that way.